Am I grabbing the TNT supply?
Is Ben gonna TNT anything? I remember when watching him in scrims, he tested out a cannon to blow up resources. They two-manned it. Could easily be countered by an extra person just bowing. So the fact that there's two people from Penumbra onto resources could work well and maybe stall that.
Pretty sure Penumbra just got sub here. I think everyone else from Penumbra is down lane.
Sub is trying to actually cannon the magic box of the enchants. Hasn't been taken by Rush. This is actually going to be pretty damn huge right now. Ben dies inside resources. I think Star Paul's also does resources. Yeah, because it's Cave Spire. It's pretty much the only place where it has it for the most part.
Oz is cannoning the stake at third. Oz is cannoning the chest with the stake. And it looks like Penumbra hasn't moved the stake out. They moved the glass out, but they didn't have him move the stake. Mm-hmm. And that cannon's going to get all the food. Yeah, all the entities are gone. That's...
Get a view of this enchant. I feel like the enchanting is really important here. And Sub gets it. All the entities explode too because it's multiple charge. That's pretty huge. I think that's what their strat's going to be here.
Both teams have not started third yet.
Cat is now, I believe, cannoning the chest. Yeah, they're going to have pretty good cannoning supplies here. I think that's what Cat was rushing. He wasn't exactly rushing for second. He was more rushing to get that chest off. I think they're trying to play a little bit of a long game, not exactly rush a wool. But this strategy could definitely work out in their favor, as I think it's now starting to work.
Died, but he got the chest before he died. Rush has no more TNT to play.
Oh yeah, Cat did die, but then it should be there. No one's starting out third yet, no early rushes. I don't think anyone's even grabbed a shovel from the top. Oh, my good friend Claff is now playing US Dust Right. Isn't that crazy?
That's so nice. Star Paul still in the resources. Ben left resources. Ultimate 7 Falcon and Subatomic Panda are both here in resources, and Paul hasn't picked up the iron. Looks like they have TNT in their hand. Maybe they can cannon it.
I don't think they didn't get the diamonds, did they? No, I think it's all cannon now. Rush are just not doing good at resources at all right now this game.
Oh, I didn't realize this. The Rush Diamond is a cannon, and the Penumbra's Diamond Paul is also cannon.
Oh, also. Okay, so both of them. That's interesting, but I think that's probably still good for Penumbra because they got the power buffs now with the enchants. So the fact that Rush doesn't have any, it's going to be really rough on PvP sections of the map, especially considering they didn't actually rush second wool at all yet. Easy. The player spread, though, it's still two people from Penumbra onto the resources.
Sub setting up a cannon for the iron right now.
TP sub. Oh, wow, they haven't even gone to iron yet? Oh, someone needs to shoot Star Paul as much as possible right now. Oh, but the can's just going to be going out for it. Unless...
Subatomic.
Sub?
A little bit slow on this cannon, but Falcon's doing his best to try to delay. Paul still needs to get three blocks.
He's getting two. Three. There's four or five blocks? Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. Paul's going to get all the iron. So, looks like no iron.
If they can shoot him! Oh, that's huge!
Well, that's huge.
That's the iron resources. Sub needs to do it now. He has 12 TNT, so that's at most, like, I don't know, four shots, I think, if he wants to really do it. Oh, it's going to do two TNT, so if he keeps this up, it's going to be three, yeah. Oh, a three-stage gun. You're right.
That's so cool. Okay, let's see if this gets...
Is it going to be enough? No, it doesn't. But Paul's at three hearts. He's still one shot. Can he escape? Kind of, but is there going to be another can sub for that? Sub should have 18 T left, unless he's crafting a mount block or something right now. I think
he can still make another.
This is huge if they can get that iron. Sorry, Paul, able to get all the way down here. I think a creeper kind of damaged him, unless that was the fall damage. Able to pick it up safely, though. I don't think they'll be able to do much at this point. Check out the rest of the map here. Ben actually starting third, it looks like, right now, onto the third platform. Nobody from Penumbra is over here, it doesn't look like. That's a little bit concerning. Although, I wouldn't say it's the worst thing in the world, especially if they have the canning supplies from second. I'm not sure if they got it back. It doesn't look like it. Enemies are still on the ground here. If they can get those back, it'd be pretty huge, especially getting a second lockdown with those power bows, but I think those entities are going to start despawning soon, especially because Cat had no resources in the first place getting down there.
Ben's going to get this third wall for free. There's no one here to contest him.
Yeah, there's just three people over by at the beginning
really
of the map.
Rush.
This is such a weird
getting third
start.
Really early on this map is such a... It's so good on this map because you can just lock down from the little blocks.
Yeah. Why are they shooting? Oh, that angle right there. Awk is helping out the resource runner, Sarpal.
So I think Cat just died in second again, but this TNT's still there.
I wonder if he picked it up to at least reset it, though.
Not sure. Probably, yeah. Hmm.
I think Subbed finally looked at the diamond room and realized there's no diamonds at all for him to get. Oh, no, he did get one block at the very least. Might be able to get
a Penumbra chest player. Actually has a little bit of a research advantage because they have all the diamond block, and they have all the iron, and they have the enchanting, but Rush only have the iron.
Yeah, it's interesting, but I think just the fact that they gave up third for all of this, it's kind of concerning. I think they really need to get that TNT from second if they want to do a good lockdown.
Yeah, Cat's trying his best to do that. This could be a good second lockdown if they get it all set up, get the TNT going, get that resource advantage, really push that resource advantage here.
The issue is
taking out a resource.
All of Penumbra's at the beginning of the map right now, and they brought back Oss all the way to start bowing down people. Like, they want them locked down that area of the map. This is kind of really concerning right now. Ben just has all the time in the world to do this. And now, look at this, they have to take their time actually getting all the way up this. They have to staircase mine the whole way through. Luckily, they have a gold pickaxe, but...
Rush actually lit up the trees at third.
Yeah, they did that right. All the time to do it.
Yeah, I guess that's true. They did have time to do that.
No power bows coming out by Rush. I wonder if, like, Penumbra should just group up right now, even though they're kind of like pincer. Just start enchanting power bows right now, even. Just having them out to help PvP. Really...
Sarpal is still in resources. He's actually going to be way far behind Subatomic and Falcon. So it looks like they have like a lot of time where they have resources and the rest don't.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Sub's gonna die. Oh, can't get around the mountain. Yes, he can. See the Indies.
Number slowly getting map control back.
Still got on the people ground. None. I think as soon as we see a giant chat log of expiration items.
Ben just completed. Did his back pass around here,
pass around. Does he have enough blocks to get out? Yeah, I think he got one of the shovels from a spawn. Oh, let's see, why does he have XP balls? That's the spectating. Very interesting. Sub is now, I believe, starting to enchant stuff right now. I wonder if he'll go for power 2, potentially power 3 or 4 bows. I remember, I think it was, not Otaku Clan.
Yeah, Otaku.
Was it Otaku? Yeah, Otaku Clan. They were able to anvil enough power bows to make a power 4. Unfortunately, in the end, they didn't get to utilize it much in first wool, but there could be a strat here that they'd like to try out. At the very least, get power bows for everyone. Cat now has full diamonds. I wonder if he can at least... I'd love to know how much time is left on this TNT, because that's going to be huge if you can get that. Especially with this diamond armor, you can kind of just run right through. There's no power bows from the opposing team.
Cap production doesn't have a water bucket. Water bucket's so useful for running that one, especially locking it down. Getting all that lava into places you can walk on.
I think all five cannon. Iron blocks, too. Like, I'm not sure. Maybe they're prioritizing more armor? And he's still there. I think they're probably gonna ignore it at this point.
Awk is like taking a beating right now. There's three people shooting him.
Yeah, look at the lane down on Penumbra's side. Just no lighting at all. They're gonna have a bunch of difficulty even getting over there. All the trees are gonna be filled with mobs just going down the whole way. And I think, all that right there. I think that's the TNT from second. That is, yes. So I think the only TNT left on the map is from the first resources in the third tree, which isn't much at all, it looks
I'm
like.
I'm pretty sure Oz can in the third tree.
He can, okay. So, Rush probably have more, but it's not enough for a good lockdown. Maybe if you can get people stuck in one position and get enough time, but...
And the TNT supply in second just despawned, so they can't
sub-lagging out. That's going to be a little bit concerning if you can't get back soon. Falcon doesn't have much as resources as well. Cat. Still got a power bow. Sub's internet crash, it looks like. That's not good.
That's unfortunate. That's really sucks.
Plus, like, one of their players wants to just stall. Just be like, yeah, 3v3. But I don't think they don't have to.
Oz just setting up cannons for third. Looks like Oz is gonna get a pretty well. I'm gonna see much. He doesn't have that much TNT. He has 35. That's enough to do a decent like, I guess. Especially at third when all of it's like based on walling up and bridging.
Yeah. Oh, Oz canning third platforms now. He's. I remember he did this in a scrim. It's pretty good, especially in the beginning of the wall. Although if someone runs right past, it's not that hard.
Caesar Paul's out of resource. It's got full iron.
Two people on Russia grouped up by the mountain. Actually, now three people in the back. Both people are setting up resources towards the back lane of it. 24 TNT in Ben's chest. Should be enough for probably six shots at most. A lot of gold and iron armor to go around. It looks like it's going to be it. No diamonds or anything. No enchants either. I highly doubt they're going to be able to out PvP. So realistically, I think most of this game is going to end up going on. Well, first, whether Sub can actually come back with his internet, or if, and then a second lockdown, if it can happen.
But the second lockdown is, it can be really strong because they don't have any diamond, and running at full iron with a bunch of people shooting you with power boosts is not. Oh, Paul just died with the.
Did you set a bed though? No, I don't even think he did.
But he's gonna get this stuff back, honestly.
Yeah, definitely. It's just the time.
Yeah. Wonder if Panama's gonna capitalize on that death. What's cap production do?
Interesting.
Cap production looks like he's.
Both teams have their lockdowns essentially. I just wonder how people are gonna get blocks on Penumbra's side. I don't think they took the shovel from the spawn to kind of get like a bunch of dirt, especially making that tunnel on the third lane that most people tend to do. It's gonna be interesting. His sub is finally joined back. He's got a. Did he have armor? Yeah, he just had gold armor for the most part. Oh, but he had all the resources as well, it looks like. So definitely should be spreading that out now. That's probably why Rush, sorry, Penumbra weren't doing much. Are we able to go to voice channels on this, or?
Does it let you?
Oh, don't think so.
Yeah, that's fine. We don't need to.
I'm not gonna ask Ben anyway, because he's at the pause.
Yeah, he's in the middle of a match. All four Penumbra players on top of the mountain right now.
Yeah, this is odd.
Yeah, looks like they're focusing on PvP right now. I got three people shooting, including Subatomic.
Is Paul able to get his stuff back? Yeah, looks like he fell in the little hole down there. Actually, he took the, Oh, this is interesting. He got the potion chest.
That's going to be really good for running second, because
I don't have
anything.
Wait, is there anything for fire res? It's a magma block, or magma cream, right? You can't really get that from.
I don't see. Yeah, I don't think you can make fires. But you can make regen too. Or regen extended.
Oh, yeah, the gas here does give you that. Well, you need glowstone. I don't know where glowstone is on this map.
There's. At the house.
Do you think he knows that? He probably knows that.
Cap production running second right now in a cry box right now. Punching his way out. Looks like his team's gonna give him cover. Just Ben shooting right now. Ben PvP, okay.
Mr. Ben PvP. Cat finally on his way back. That creeper spawned right into the void. Does he have a water bucket though? No, he does not. And actually doesn't have many blocks to work with. I'm really surprised he's running this right now, although. Parkour
to be
is
honest,
way
you
down. He's got about 30 muck, so like he can definitely get to the wool box. I just question if he's gonna get out, really.
You can use the wool digger.
Oh my god. That's rough.
Yeah, it sucks.
Man, Ben and Oz are gonna be over in this direction too, so they're probably gonna be
god. Look at Penumbra's third, like the.
Yeah, they have like.
Yeah, like, look at how many mobs there are.
No, I can't even see, like, long distance, but. Cat, come on. Almost there. He's still one shot by an archer. Oh, no, he has no blocks to, like, run anywhere. Oh, what a disaster.
He has got to get the fence, I guess. He's got to punch fences.
Punch a fence!
Oh, no, he's just. I don't know what he's.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's gonna like
that's
break it
work,
and pick it up. Oh
it's
no!
Oh
no no!
He's gonna need more blocks to get back.
Yeah, definitely.
And I do have a bed set right behind the second, so it doesn't take that long to get back, especially since they have so much control in this area.
Yeah, he spawns right next to it. It should be like at least 3 minutes left till it despawns. I think he's got plenty of time.
Sub's trying to light up the lane at third.
I think they should just wait for daytime at this point. Like, it's just 2 minutes away. Just like, regroup. Help out Cat get down. Especially because Sub needs to regen health now. Hawk
so
dies,
if you look at the
Ben
chat right
dies.
Now, it looks like Penumbra is getting all the kills right now.
Yeah, this is interesting. Yeah, that's because of the power bows, really, it looks like.
Yeah. And Falcon and Why Am I Playing MC are having a good game. They're both doing really well. They're really putting the pressure on the rush.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Sub. I think Sub might be looking for more food soon. No, he's got plenty. I think Cat. Yeah, he's just punching logs. I'm surprised none of them have the axes from the spawn. Well, Sub does, but he's just not helping Cat punch a tree. Hawk over here on the top of the mountain. Probably going to start trying to do a little bit of lockdown second. They already have third wool, so they can do the third lockdown, which shouldn't be that bad. I just feel like second lockdown is so much easier with TNT, but both teams don't have it. So I can easily see both of them getting it soon. And of course, as I say in that, Sarpal is actually running it right now. I don't think people really know that it's happened. Oh, does he see the creeper? He does. Okay, the creeper was like right next to him.
Didn't put any torches here, so they. So
yeah, like, it's like. I barely noticed it too.
Yeah. Okay.
They're so tunnel vision on the archers on top that they don't notice this at all.
Yeah, they don't notice Paul getting all this. Paul's obsidianizing. Paul's that's water rock is really useful.
He might be going. Does he notice that the chest is gone?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Rush noticed that they cannoned it, because I remember Aqua shooting Cad when he was shooting the cannon.
Yeah, but it's weird, because it's only the chest that blew up, so he could be like, oh, maybe the chest isn't rendering. Oh my god, that's the most annoying sound ever.
Oh, the mountain again. Looks like Awk and Oz just killed the two PvPers of the other team. Paul has... running the wall with no contestion at all.
Yeah, Penumbra's shovel still spawn, Ghibli.
Oh my god, all the there's a bunch of mobs grouped up in this lake in Penumbra.
Oh god, this happens every scrim too.
So that's pretty funny. Okay, Ben's just hanging out at third, just checking if they're gonna do it or not.
Someone's running first now on Penumbra's side. This is kinda interesting. Sub. Has a flame skeleton on him. He's doing it in full gold. Definitely possible. It's just really rough there. Gonna have to take some time regenerating health at the very least.
Cap production stuff.
So you get it?
No, it's gone.
Oh, it's
I don't see
tag.
Any more diamond. Yeah, that sucks.
Why
there's
is
no more.
No, the skeleton or the zombie has it. Fuck.
Oh, that's.
Yeah, he picked it up. The other resources are still there. So at least the good stuff won't, unless like a zombie pushes him out, which would be pretty damn funny. Yeah, Cat just, I don't know where he's, it's in leather armor. I think he wants to drop down, but he's at 3 hearts, so he's going to take way too much fall damage and die. Like, I think those items will despawn. He's just thankful that a zombie picked it up.
It looks like Penumbra is losing this mountain battle right now. Where's Falcon? Falcon went to go third, that's why. Yeah, but Cat can't really enter this wall as long as Awk and Oz are up there shooting. Yeah, this is heavily in Rush's favor right now. They got two of the walls.
Yeah, I think those items that just despawned in the chat. I think that was Cat's.
And a second. Is that like the final blaze spawner? Obsidianized everything up to the point.
As you're saying that, Sub's at 1 heart, but he's all the way down, getting close to the last room of first. Very interesting. Sarpal now has this. They have 2 wolves that they can start locking down here. Not looking like a good position here for Penumbra at all. Cat Productions trying to finally come down, or no, Ultimate 7 Falcon, I mean. He's at 3 hearts, trying to get shots of ball. Oh, Cat. Oh, no.
Oh, Cat
Productions. Yeah. unfortunate there. Let's check out Sub doing first. He's got the baby zombies on top of the cave spires now. It's gonna be rough. A lot of them spawning in. He's trying to bow them down. I don't think he has an Ender Pearl or anything to really help him out. TNT, not even. Water Bucket could potentially flow it, the like mobs away. It's not good. Over on the other end, Falcon's still stuck in the box over here on second. Cat just cannot get back. He's having such a rough game at this point.
Falcon's having a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
He's getting pinned down by... It was a shooting. Ox shooting over there. Yeah, Ox and Oz doing a really good job controlling this mountain.
Yeah, they don't have a power boost either.
Yeah. Ox and Oz farming all the kills right now.
What went wrong this game for Penumbra? Like, I feel like their strat works. It's just...
I think the biggest thing was all stuff and Cat dying in second to that creeper. Because if Cat like finished second there, they'd be have a much easier time locking down that wall.
He died multiple times there too. He died in the very beginning, like the rush that they had, because they had such a huge lead. I'm not sure if they wanted to actually rush it. They may have just been like, "Damn, they're all stuck on spot. Let's change it." But even the second time, you still died.
They rushed second in the scrim we had. So I'm pretty sure
they did.
Yeah.
Well, most of us were at third and we didn't notice, but like, Rush just like knew because they were running from the first area. So it should have been very obvious. Oh, jeez, that TNT. Oh, Falcon. I don't even think he has much to work with. Oh, never mind, he's got armor. Where did that cannon come from?
Sorry, I called Drink Potions. I think he might be bringing Strength Potions first. Yeah, this is Blaze Powder for Strength Potions. So first we're gonna be like three with those Strength 2. Can one-shot mobs with Iron Sword and Strength 2, by the way. Mm-hmm. Balanced Potion.
Yeah, it's probably good since he can't get a sharp Diamond Sword or even just an Iron Sword at this point.
Subatomic farming blocks in the first wall. Probably healing up farming blocks at the same time, I guess.
Third wall has just been untouched the whole game by Penumbra. They have no reason to want to go over there. I don't even think they like want to lock down anything at this point. Like, Sub is still at the beginning of the last room of first. Like, he's not getting anything done. He's got a bunch of XP orbs, but they're going to keep spawning if he's close. I think he just needs to book it. He's got enough health. And as I say that, these cave swords are probably going to bite him. And yes, it does. It's going to push him back the whole way through. He might be better off just running out completely, I'd say. Cat Productions now gonna try going over the third, probably to get more resources from those chests.
We got, why am I playing MC hanging by the third, first area probably. But this is the last one they need, I guess they have to do this. I'm gonna lock down this area. Or they tried it. Caesar Paul climbing up the mountain. Not sure what he's doing here. Oh, he's grabbing this chest. Yeah. Okay, Rush also has an Ender Pearl as well, so their VM run is basically secure.
It's kind of good by Cat, actually. He's got two people on him, so they should technically have a man advantage on the rest of the map, although realistically it's still a 2v2 onto the mountain.
Caesar Paul has Regeneration 2 and Strength 2, so this first wall is going to be like, I want to watch this first one, it's going to be so fun. It's just going to run.
Check this out, too, yeah.
It's going to take like 2 seconds.
How many torches you got? He's got plenty of torches, yeah. You got a good point for him, too.
Just part of the strength.
Check this out.
One shot the creeper, one shot all these mobs.
Clock it in. What's the record going to be? Here we go. Bing, bam, boom. Run it down, torch it down. Break spires? Yeah, sure. I might as well. I got time. No efficiency pick? No need. Zombie, spider, skedaddle. Get out of my way. Cobwebs?
Oh my.
Nope. Zombie, give me gunpowder? Nah, you can wear a chain helmet. This is just, easy for Sarpaul. Actually, he got a lot of mobs on him, though.
Subatomic left? Oh, Subatomic died in first one.
How'd he die?
I have no idea. I see a stuff on the ground, though.
Probably better than waiting a whole minute to regen 10 hearts, to be honest.
Slump Atomic back in the wall. Caesar Paul one-shotting everything in his sight.
I'm just going inside his perspective on Spectre Booth. Seeing how the man does it himself.
Oh my god. I don't think he's like been below 7 hearts the whole time.
Yeah. Wow. It's like we're inside Star Paul's mind right here. We can really analyze what he's thinking right now. He's thinking, man, I think it's time to eat. That's all I can really analyze.
Star Paul potting up again. Gonna kill my mobs.
Let them go. Oh, Cave Spider. There we go.
Star Paul just leveled up.
How do I get at him? There we go. He just leveled up.
How many levels do you think he has? Oh, he's got 25 levels. Jesus Christ. Could make a what? Power 4 again.
Yeah, and they brought Falcon over to start shooting him now, but doesn't matter, it's too late, unless he can blow it up. I don't see if it's doing much. Oh, he's getting low! 4 hearts! Oh, he's gonna get cornered, he's cornered! Come on, if that cave zombie, cave spider can get him. Oh, there's mobs inside the spider place too. That regen too just saved his ass completely.
Oh, he took so many hits and he still lived.
Yeah. That's crazy.
I'm potting up another regen. Subatomic, and why am I playing MC trying to do the swastikle? I mean, trying to do this first wall. Why am I MC?
Just swastikle?
Subatomic is probably gonna die. Yeah, he died.
Yeah, that Paul gets that pretty quick.
Well, this was looking so good for Penumbra too. Like, that start was insane.
I think they had the strat. They really did. It's just...
Yeah, they had an advantage.
Like, it was not executed at all the way it should have.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
I guess the experience just really shows from Rush, like, even though they are really far behind the start, they still managed to pull this out pretty clean. Because, you know, their adaptation skills are pretty good, I guess.
It's really good, yeah. Cat trying to run third now. I don't think it's going to do too much there. Ben's probably just going to run all the way down. He's got the whole wall to himself. He can just get every angle that he needs. Have we gone second wall for Falcon? Did he pick it up? Yes, he did. I didn't even notice that in the chat. Unable to get it out, though. Looks like... I think he died in the... Yeah. So Lime Wool finally getting placed around safety touches. So Penumbra coming out first with 2 people. Now they pretty much need third. They kind of have second secured-ish.
Caesar Paul has all 3 wolves and the Ender Pearl, and he's pearling right now.
Oh, he's pearling now. And
yep,
that's GG. Anytime now. Boom. How long did that take? The match summary.
30 minutes ish.
I'll post this in the Twitch chat for you guys.
And 39
seconds. 30 minutes, 39 seconds, yeah.
Pretty good game though.
Yeah, like, I don't want to say that like anyone throws, everyone hates hearing that, but I got really through that, I think. It's really
okay.
Unfortunate.
Yeah. Everyone had bad games. We saw it earlier. A lot of individual players through.
You'd rather have it in the group stage too than anywhere else.
Yeah.
If I'm being honest. Oh.
But it was a good showing by Penumbra. Like you could tell they really, really practiced that start.
Yeah.
Like, I know Cat messed up a little with that second rush, but they got the cannon supply. They did really well on the resources. They put a lot of pressure on Paul and Ben, which both died. They lost their diamond, they lost their enchanting, and they almost got the iron as well.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I think we're gonna do a little post game interview too. Some of the players.
Yeah, we'll move Ben and Sub in.
Oh, hello, strangers.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Paul.
What's up?
Hello, Paul M. Hayes. PvP Master.
PM Hayes.
PM Hayes.
Hey, Sub.
Good game. A little trickery there, but.
Wait, what trickery? Oh.
The Bedrock Hole.
What Bedrock Hole?
Bedrock Hole.
The one in second where you mine right into the one hole.
It's been there since forever.
Wait, you mined?
Yeah.
Wait, did you get into second at the Bedrock Hole?
It's not a Bedrock Hole. I mean, it is technically, but it's been there for.
Oh, what the fuck? I didn't even know about this.
Since, wait,
what?
Like the original version of it.
Oh, man. Strange. That's how we got in the wall. Look, there's a Bedrock Hole here at the potion chest.
Yeah. If we'd seen you down there, then that would have been one thing, but.
My fucking perspective's so funny because I'm like looking straight up and I can see. I think it's Falcon on top
what
of
the fuck?
Shooting everybody else.
Yeah, I never knew about this.
Yeah.
You do have the mine 3 obsidian, though.
Yeah, I just used a gold pick, though, so it's not too bad.
That's very interesting, actually, because he gets to brew the strength pots, too. And because you guys didn't have enchants, that makes kind of sense.
What I did was I brewed the regen there because you need the blaze rods from the end of second.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
To get the strength, and then there's glowstone everywhere, and that's how I just ran first.
That makes sense, yeah. I was gonna say, why does he need the potions? Like, you have a fire res? I'm like, that's stupid. Why
the fire
res
is just from the chest. I keep it in case I get shot in lava.
Yeah.
But I was just using potions on the map every time, because it's so much faster to run first with it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what was everyone's strats coming into this game? I'll start with Rush. What was the strat there, and what like kind of threw you off in the beginning?
So like our main focus was obviously third, or like we wanted to get third done first and lock that down with cannons for the entirety of the game. But they got our cannon supplies, so that hurt. And then resources just turned into a fucking pain loop. And we got all of our iron, which is nice. Your cannon missed big time.
Barely. It was actually barely. Like, it was if like, I had waited, like maybe a quarter of a second later for my second on the three stage, then it would have gotten it right in there.
Right, that would have been sketchy then.
It would have been fucking huge.
Huge.
Yeah. The fact that you guys died in second with your diamond, I assume, because
I don't know how that happened, dude. I don't know.
I definitely killed multiple mobs wearing diamond armor to make sure it would despawn.
I know how it happened. A creeper.
Yeah, I got a creeper right on the face or something.
It was. He had all the time in the world to kill it, too. Or, like, even knock it further back, I'm pretty sure.
Well, we absolutely. I mean, I'm pretty sure we completely dominated resources, but after that, we couldn't press it.
It was like definitely. You definitely won resources. The fact that we got iron, I think. Dominate, you know?
I think the fact,
you definitely had a good lead.
If he did get the iron, it would have been bad.
That you did was really, really close to getting the.
I know, that's what I was saying. Like, quarter of a second, it would have gotten everything, Paul and all of his iron.
Why don't you try it again? Oh, actually, no, it was an hour too late. Picked up.
Yeah,
I forgot.
Yeah.
And
I didn't even know you can endure enchanting or diamond until I got there and was like, oh, well. Gold helmets for all.
Yeah, we came up with our own enchanting cannon that works like 100% of the time, but then we also saw we do want to mention that diamond cannon was the puff puff cannon, so the one that they came up with. We hadn't implemented that until very late.
I was going to do that one too, cuz Upland sent us like a gif of it basically.
Yeah.
But then I was just like, ah, fuck it. We're in a bad situation, that cannon, I'm not like 100% sure on it, and I know I can just push two buttons with the Bedrock Hole cannon really easy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sub, what about you? What was your strat coming into it?
Up until actually 15 minutes before the match, we were doing some really like really weird strat where we just pop into resources, get enchants, and deny the other enchants and leave. Mm-hmm. And then like from that point, we just. We thought that we could. I mean, enchanting is just way too good.
It's just way
too overwhelming. So if you get that and deny it from the other team, that puts you ahead like by a ton. Even if they have diamonds, like power bows and diamond armor, it still hurts.
Mm-hmm.
But then we changed it to, since we kept getting, like, same thing kept happening in scrims where everybody would just, they would send, like, maybe two to resources, and then we would just get fucked, and then our strat just fell apart. So we decided, you know what, we're going all in. We're just going to do resources and then just win the map. But then we just totally missed Paul doing that dig in a second, and that ruined everything. Talk about linchpins.
When I upload this, you'll see how funny it is, because I can very clearly see somebody directly across the lane from me, like, shooting everybody except me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but to be honest, it's not one of the things that you look for when you're playing the show. I didn't even know about the dig, and I don't think Falcon or the your new guy knew about it either. So they weren't really looking at it in areas.
I'm pretty sure every time I've done it in, like, scrims, they've never seen it either.
Yeah, there's also another thing where right at about the nighttime, like when nighttime just fell, I DC'd for like 5 minutes because I accidentally kicked my router. So I DC'd for like 5 minutes.
You had the resources too, like you didn't spread it all out at the time, so everyone had to like group up for a time being because they're like, ah, shit, yeah. We still got light and gold.
It was fucking lame as hell, dude. I was so pissed.
Yeah.
Like, but we did get first and we touched second. Mm-hmm. We weren't able to pass second round though, so.
Yeah, you guys didn't even light up third. It was a mess over there.
Third, I'm pretty sure we wouldn't. If we got to hold out on our second, like if the Paul thing didn't happen, then we probably would have had plenty of time because we've got like, you can bridge that wall where it's like completely out of sight for like half of it. Mm-hmm. Even if you're in the wall, it's like toxic as fuck.
Yeah,
there's like no cool cannons in that map. Just to like stop bridging at all.
Yeah, does he do the one, you know how you do the trapdoor thing on the back of the lane?
What?
To like bridge on the very back of the lane, you can like use trapdoors to get down to the
lane.
Yeah, so if you do that, like Aus's cannons are great, but they probably don't destroy them all the way.
I'm curious now. We've never had anyone do that against us. Like it was rough one game. We had Poon Army like locked out of even getting into the wall. It was really funny. Jeez.
So even though you guys lost, I felt like you guys had a pretty good showing. Like there was a period where like Ultimate Sun Falcon and Why Am I Playing Minecraft was like fucking awesome. All
yeah.
Like they were getting like they were like farming them. And yeah. Like you guys had like full control of the mount and cap production was running the wall. It was looking really good.
Honestly, I couldn't be more proud of the showing for us like that. Mm-hmm. Coming up against number one seed, like fuck me, dude. We played way too well for that to be.
You had the strat, it just didn't execute the way it should have.
Yeah. Things didn't happen quite the way we planned.
Yeah, I played the start, but luckily like the running the wolves part went smooth.
Was rushing second always a part of the strat, or like because you guys held rush off and like spawn for like a good while too in the beginning. So I was like, oh, Cat's getting down the lane too. But then like he actually went all the way into the wall. I was like, and then he died at one point. I'm like, it's kind of concerning because usually if you rush it, I feel like people don't notice it once they're by third area. But when they're coming back from spawn, I feel like it's so noticeable. And I feel like that's probably why he could have died. So it was definitely weird.
I think Cat's first death was a PvE death, if I recall.
Oh, was it? I swear he was shot.
Pretty sure he got killed by Creeper, and then he got fireballed by Blaze, and then...
That's unfortunate.
Got Creepered with full enchanted armor. But anyway, that became the linchpin of our strategy.
Yeah,
because
that was full
that
diamond,
shot,
pretty much.
So. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, it was a good game. I think that we have a really good shot at... like actually going places in this tournament, so
that was fun.
Yeah, I like I like
type.
Oh, sorry.
I was just gonna say I had a tight butthole most of that game. Clinched.
What were you gonna say, Buck?
Oh, I was just saying. Oh, I forgot what I was gonna say. No, that's nice. Okay. I don't think it was anything important.
It's never important, Buck.
Of course.
All right. Well, I do think we have another match coming soon, right?
It's my match, yeah.
Impact versus Bulletproof.
That's in 45 minutes, yeah.
That could be pretty fun.
Yeah, I'm excited to watch. All right.
Dude, except for the fact, like, how you slapped us around in scrims. Like, I don't know. Literally, just like every time we scrimmed Impact, they just like CFI threw us out. Like, it was terrible.
You guys won, like, the first one, but then I think we scrimmed 5 more times or something, and then, like, a few of them were like, yikes.
We didn't even touch a wool in one of them, and I don't know if that's happened in a long time.
Yeah.
But, like, in our defense, we were never, like, we had strats, but they were never, like,
they're test strats. Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like, I think you tried out, like, a full rush strat. Like,
oh. Yeah,
it was close, actually, to beating us.
I wanted to use that now, because I thought we could pull that off. Like, all four of us basically just blitzing everything again.
Yeah, especially because there's already, like, pre-made gold armor across the map, too. Like, it's not that bad of an idea, especially in the beginning.
It's such a BM strat.
It definitely is, too. Like, maybe against, like, a bad opponent in the first round, but, like, Umbra probably wouldn't work against.
I feel like you're taking a shot at someone there.
Yeah.
Blitzing all the wolves against a low seed opponent.
I mean,
why?
A low seed for
we
a
both
reason.
Didn't do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we'll see you later. Good game, guys.
Yeah.
Good game.
All right, I'm gonna end the stream there. Come back at 8 o'clock, I think. Yeah, it's our match. The Impact and Bulletproof. I don't know who's streaming that, but I'll be back on this channel. Yeah. Follow the Discord. And stuff. Yeah. Okay.